Good morning, New Canaan High School. I'm Dominic Maitino, coming to you live from the NCTV studio. Today is September 22nd and a day G.
And I'm Annie Manalia. I hope you all enjoyed your day off yesterday, and we have plenty of stories for you today. But before we get into it, may everyone please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Earlier this week, there was a Voices of September 11th assembly in the Wagner Room for some juniors. There was a singer and a pledge to the flag to open the assembly, followed by introductory comments by Mr. Webb. Students then watched a student-produced video remembering the events of 9/11. And later, a few presentations from intern Emma Smith, Noah Levine, Jake Neuberger, and Grant Wang, as well as a few words from Frank and Mary Fetchett, the directors. After the assembly, NCTV caught up with Jake and Emma to see what their experience with the program was like.
We really were able to learn a lot of lifelong skills that'll help us no matter what career path we choose.
Yeah, definitely. I agree with that. Whether it's working 9 to 5, dressing appropriately for the workspace, and also just learning how to interview and some basic skills that you need definitely apply to like lifelong future careers.
NCTV was there to film the rest of the event too, so look for it up on our channel soon.
The Gay Straight Alliance Club is hosting a bake sale on Monday during all three lunches. The money raised will go directly to the Montrose Center to help rebuild Houston after Hurricane Harvey.
The Service League of Boys is having their first general meeting of the year tomorrow at 2 in the cafeteria. The Slobs will be hosting Charlie Holmes from the New Canaan Exchange Club as their guest speaker. They'll also be accepting donations of men's clothing for the Midnight Run, as well as donations for hurricane relief. Also, don't forget, if you plan on attending, make sure to bring a parent and sign in at the meeting.
Open house is this upcoming Monday. Class visitations will begin at 7:15 p.m. with a special orientation for freshman parents at 6:30 p.m. in the auditorium. With that comes the opening night of the summer art show in the main lobby. The art show features works from teachers and students in many different forms, including videos from Charlie Hain, Isaac Marshall, and Jack Dunn. Of course, some traditional art will also be featured. The gallery will be open for a while, so don't be afraid to stop by and admire the beautiful work.
If you can't make it to the art show, the theater department's annual car wash is this weekend. We go to NCTV's Caitlin Piotrowski, who has more information on the event.
Caitlin Piotrowski, if you don't want to spend hours this weekend washing your car yourself, come on down on Saturday to the New Canaan High School parking lot, where the theater department will be hosting their annual car wash. For only $10 from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m., you can get your car squeaky clean, and it'll help go to support the rest of the shows for the year. Now, my parents are making me clean my car this week, but I'll still be down there helping wash some other cars this weekend. I hope to see you there.
Caitlin, I'm excited to drive to school in my newly cleaned car.
Me too, Dom. Speaking of squeaky clean, we'll hand you over to our always dapper-looking sports reporter, Schaefer Jones. Schaefer, how you doing?
I'm doing great, Annie. Thanks for asking. But remember, it's all for the fans. Hey, NCHS, how you doing? While the fall season is just a few weeks underway, there's plenty to discuss and get you caught up on. I'm Schaefer Jones, and this is the Rams Sports Report. Let's start things off with one of my favorite programs here at school, girls field hockey. Even though the girls won states just 10 months ago, it appears they're off to a rocky start. On Tuesday, the girls took the long trek up to Cheshire, where they fell to the knockoff Rams 2-1. Hopefully, the girls are able to improve upon their 2-2 record today when they take on Brian McMahon at 4. The game is at home, so if you're free and feel in the mood for a doubleheader with football afterwards, stop on by and support the girls. Speaking of the pigskin sport, the football team was able to pick up their first win on Friday over Danbury. In their classic scorched earth fashion, they bulldozed the Hatters 42-7. But this wasn't just another win thrown into the books. This victory marked the 332nd win for Coach Lou Marinelli, who now holds the state record for the most wins in its history. Incredible. In the 37 years that Coach Marinelli has manned the helm of New Canaan football, he's finished with 33 winning seasons, 5 FCAC titles, and 12 state championships, including his current streak of 4. With a historic showing as good as that, it's enough to make Coach Lou Marinelli our Ram of the Week. The Rams are now 1-1 and will take on Trumbull tonight at 7. While the Golden Eagles share the same 500 record as us, in their loss to Greenwich, which they were outscored 70-16, it was pretty telling about how their team's doing. My money's on us for this one. After starting off the season hot with a 2-0 record, girls volleyball would fall to 500 by Monday, with consecutive losses to both Danbury and Greenwich. It wouldn't take long, however, for them to bounce back as they beat Willen on Tuesday, but the four-game week just proved to be a little too much for them as they would fall to Joe Barlow the next day. The girls' next contest will come on Monday after they've had some time to rest up. It will be a home matchup versus Bridgeport Central. Now on to boys' soccer. The boys' season isn't exactly off to an ideal start as they are 1-3-1 through their first five games, but the boys are hoping that that's not an indication of how the rest of the season will go. Dealing with a slew of injuries, the guys' roster has taken a beating, which showed in their 3-1 loss to Stanford. But not all is lost. With three quarters of the season left, the team has more than enough time to bring back their starters and right the ship. Hopefully the guys can start doing that this afternoon when they take on Trinity Catholic at 4. On the other hand, girls' soccer has been doing slightly better than the boys. After demolishing both Bridgeport Central and Stanford earlier this week, both by a score of 8-0, the girls' record is now 2-1-2. Standout performances by captain Julia Ojimic and freshman Emma Hsu helped secure the win over the Black Knights, as both girls netted 2 goals. Their next game is this afternoon at Connor Field, and the matchup is against Trinity Catholic. It will kick off at 4. And last but certainly not least, the only undefeated team left this fall, girls swimming and diving. That's right, ladies, I did not forget about you. The girls have already beaten both Fairfield Ward and St. Joe's by at least 30 points each. They will try to maintain their winning record as they play Trumbull next Wednesday. Well, with that, the clock has just ran out for me. Thanks again for tuning in. This has been Schaefer Jones with your Rams Sports Report. Dom and Annie, back to you guys.
Thanks, Schaefer. I'm looking forward to our first home win, and just like that, I hope this weekend weather continues to hold up.
Yeah, Annie, I'm hoping for some good weather, too, and with all that that Mother Nature has brought us, I'm hoping we can look at some good weather.
Let's go to Caitlin Mulcahy to tell us more about our first day of fall and this weekend's weather.
Thanks, guys. That's right. Now, although this is the first weekend of fall, it sure won't feel like it. While this past week was gorgeous, this weekend temperatures will continue to rise with the sun peeking out. Good morning, NCHS. I'm Caitlin Mulcahy, here to give you this weekend's weather. Today we'll have partly cloudy skies with temperatures warming up to 79 degrees with a chilly low of 64. So if you're planning to show some school spirit and catch the game, be sure to bring a jacket. Moving on to Saturday, the clouds are here to stay. Temperatures will remain around the same with a high in the 80s and a low of 67. So this will be a great chance to visit some of the local orchards and get in your first apple picking of the season. Now, if you thought Saturday was a beaut, Sunday will be even better as the clouds will move through, leaving behind sunny skies and the high of the weekend with temperatures reaching up to 85 degrees. Well, guys, this weekend will be warmer, so make sure to get outside and capture some Insta-worthy pics.
Thanks, Caitlin. Now, before we go, we would like to wish a very fine birthday to Ava Edmonds, Anna Higgins, Anna Milai, Andrew Poli, Elizabeth Poli, and George Radoslavov. If you have any announcements, be sure to email us at nctv78@gmail.com or tweet at us at nctv78 a week before the Friday broadcast. This has been Dominic Martino.
And I'm Annie Manalia. Now, teachers, don't forget to vote for your student of the month, and I hope to see you all at the game tonight. Have a great weekend, NCHS.
This is how we do it down in Puerto Rico. I just wanna hear you screaming, ay bendito. I can go forever cuando esté contigo. Pasito a pasito, suave, suave.